comedy for BBC Two now. She's a star of BBC Three, and we get to see her best bits with some strong language. Little Miss Jocelyn.
The story began with a push and a shove. I left the two parents with a bundle of love. A couple years on and the fun never ends. Always up to mischief, playing with her friends. In her teens, she discovered the desire to perform, but found it difficult being shy and withdrawn. So sit back, relax, grab your lager or wine, because she bring a little something that will tickle your spine.
It's on again, ladies and gentlemen. Little Miss Jocelyn, so once again.
Wow, Miss Jocelyn.
Okay, I'll just type all that in. I'm really sorry, Miss Benlos, but it would appear the flight's been double booked. But we can get you on our next one at 11:25.
No, that's no good for me. I have to be in a meeting in approximately 3 hours, so I must go now.
Well, I'm afraid that won't be possible. I'm really sorry, but the next flight is the best we can do for you.
Do you have any idea how important I am to this company? I demand that you extricate someone from their seat and you get me on that flight, and I shall not leave here until you do so. Do you understand?
I'm really sorry. You're going to have to get the 11:25 or... Okay, well, let me see what I can do, but I can't... Look, I'm really sorry,
no,
but I can't...
No, 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 no!
OK, we've got one more seat available on the flight.
Thank you.
Enjoy your flight.
Come on, love. I was literally 2 minutes.
But my sign clearly states that you cannot park here at any given time. It does not say that you cannot park here, open brackets, unless you are here for literally 2 minutes, semicolon, the warden of traffic will turn a blind eye, close brackets. No, it is not conducive with the law.
Look, I know I shouldn't have parked here. I'll be off in 2 seconds.
If you make any attempts to penetrate your vehicle, I will conjunctivate you in the name of Queen Elizabeth II. Mm-hmm. I work for Queen and Country. I have been personally chosen by Her Majesty to bring justice to her roads.
You people make me sick. What are you going to do if I just drive off?
Let me explain to you why I have strategically placed the keys to your vehicle inside my confiscation. I will explain this to you while I write to you a ticket. This will take a long time.
Morning, everyone. I want to introduce you to our new member of staff. He's going to be working in accounts with you, Fiona, so can you show him the ropes?
Oh, well, you know me. After Bacardi Breeze, I'll show anything.
God, that's so funny. Come on, Keith. Don't be shy.
Yes, Keith. Where are you?
Hello. You'll have a right laugh without Fiona, so I'll put you two opposite each other. So, I'll let you get on.
Hi. I don't know why I was so nervous. Everyone seems really nice. Brian said I get on really well with him.
Well, I don't know why he said that.
Well, you're so popular. Everyone really loves you from what I've heard.
Look, just go away.
Sorry, maybe that didn't come out right. I don't want to get off on the wrong foot.
Can I just stop you there? Yeah? Now, I don't know what pirate radio station you've come from or whom you mugged to get in here.
What are you going on about?
I don't want you asking me for recipes for rice and peas.
What makes you think I want anything from you? I mean, I was just paying you a compliment. What's your problem?
Look, I've been working here for 7 years now, and no one, absolutely no one knows I'm black. And I'd like to keep it that way.
And your point is?
Well, you being here is just making me blacker.
Are you taking the piss? You are black.
Can you try and keep it down? You're not in Brixton now, you know. And if you must use the B word, I'd rather you said urban.
Oh, I see. So that's how the song goes. Bar, bar, urban sheep.
You can't laugh like that in here.
Like what?
Well, that thing you just did, the Peckham laugh. Yes, I have heard them.
You know what? I don't think I want to be anywhere near you. You're messed up, man.
How dare you speak patois to me? Yes, I'd rather your desk wasn't so close to mine. Don't want your blackness rubbing off on me. Next thing you know, I'll be squatting in the canteen and getting Bob Marley CDs for my birthday and doing my Rusty Lee impression at the Christmas party. You can't do that in here.
Do what?
That. Do you have chicken in your teeth? Haven't you people heard of dental floss?
What do you mean, you people? You're no different to me. In their eyes, you're as black as my ass.
I knew it. It didn't take long for you to draw attention to your sexual prowess, you savage beast. Now, you listen to me. I'm not interested in how big your penis is. Mr. Bombastic, semi-fantastic, touch me, pull me back, Mr. Mr. Now, look what you made me do! Stay away from me!
Story began with a push and a shove. Always up to mischief, playing with her friends. The fun never ends. The fun never ends.
Oh, babe, she's so beautiful.
I know.
It's just amazing, isn't it? Is breastfeeding supposed to be this painful?
Give it time, babe. You'll get used to it.
Yeah. She just bit me.
Stop exaggerating.
Oh, she just bit me again. Get her off me, you take her.
Mummy's a bit tired now, but she'll feed you in a bit. No, no, no. There's no milk in there.
See, I'm calling my mum. That ain't right.
Sweet mother, I won't forget you. The way you suffer, wait, suffer for me. Yeah, come on, man, come. Sweet mother, I won't forget you. The way you suffer away, suffer for me.
Shut up! I have a visa.
Me also.
You see, what I'm saying is this. If you're not happy at work, then you should walk out. That's what I will do. Use my 2 feet and walk. Even if I had 1 foot, I would hop.
Hey, come on, fast, fast. I don't got time.
Don't got time. Look out, there's a cyclist coming.
Are they wearing flashy, flashy jacket?
No.
Then I can't see them. These cyclists are useless. Always moving around quietly, as if cycling is a secret. If I had a bike, I would be ringing my ringy ringer all the way down the road so that everybody will know I am there. And if I had no ringy ringer, hey, I would make pring, pring, pring. Oh, I don't got time.
You don't got time?
Hello? I will come up Winchester Road and I will park on the corner. Hey, what is one way? It's either this way or that way. I don't got time.
I thought you had to be there at 5.
And what time is it now?
5:45.
But in Nigerian time.
4.
Hey, so I'm Ollie. Okay, sit in the back. Are you ready for your lesson? Come on, fast, fast. Don't go far.
You don't got time.
Shut up.
Oh, babe, look at little toes. I just want to eat them.
Yeah, she's got my toes.
I wonder what she's thinking. No. She's supposed to be crying, aren't you?
Well, maybe she needs changing.
I've just done that. Oh my God, what is that sound? No.
Look, she's a baby. Babies cry. Leave it to me. Mummy's tired because of all your crying, but Daddy's here now.
See, I'm calling my mum. That ain't right.
Wow, Miss Charles! Can you hear me now?
Stop making noise on my upper deck! You will burn in hell!
Can you hear me now? What about now? Can you hear me now? What about now? What about now? What about now? Now? Hello?
You have to shout in my ear.
Alicia, let's open the window. Oh.
Yeah. Sure, Alicia.
Yeah, we're rude. We open the window. And now we need to open the other window, ain't it, Nalisha?
Yeah, sure, Nisha.
Oh, ain't it cold?
Yeah, ain't it drafty?
Yeah, it is actually. It's giving me osteophonitis. Can you shut it? But not all the way. And not open, open. But not close, close. Can it go halfway?
God's sake.
But do you own this bus?
Yeah. Is your name 159? No. Is your first name 1 and your last name 59? Is your first name 15 and your last name 9? Is your first name 1 and your middle name 5 and your last name 9? Oh?
Yeah. Are you a bus?
No, Natalie, that don't make sense. Because I was trying to show that the bus was named after him, so his name must be 159. But that's because he owns the bus. But he ain't a bus, just like you ain't a dog, but you own a dog, and you can bring the dog on the bus as long as it's on a lead. And you better open that window because I've got chlamydia and it needs air.
Why do you have to be so loud? You're sitting next to each other. You're practically on each other's laps.
That's because my earring is caught in her hair.
Sorry.
No. Leave it. We want it like this because we're rude. Oh. Take it out slowly because I think my ear is bleeding.
I've got worms.
Yes, coming.
Hello, I'm Miranda Stewart. Dr. Fanshawe sent me to you.
Mm-hmm. Take off your coat and stand on the scales. Ooh, you are heavy. The government does not want you to be this fat. If you look at my chart, you are here. You are red. The government does not want you to be red. The government wants you to be orange.
Can I be yellow?
No. The government does not want you to be yellow. If you are yellow, you are underweight. The government wants you to be orange. If you like, you can be terracotta. But the government does not want you to be red. Now, I want you to tie this around your neck, and while you sleep, only dream of orange. If you dream of red, You cannot be helped. This is your last appointment. Save yourself! Save yourself! Save yourself!
Thanks for coming, Julia. You've been great.
It's no problem. You're gonna be all right?
Yeah, I've gotta be, for Mum's sake. She's the one that's lost a sister. Hey, why don't you say hello? She hasn't seen you for ages.
Oh, I don't mean to be funny, but I'd rather not. I'm no good in these situations. I never know what to say.
You don't have to say anything. Oh, look, here she comes. Mum, you remember Julia? She just wanted to say hello.
Oh, yes, of course. How are you, Julia? So sorry.
Knock three times, then howl at the moon. And howl at the moon.
Oh!
Good. Come in.
Sorry.
No. Come in. Come in.
Hello. You Florence?
Mm-hmm.
Dr. Fanshawe sent me.
Mm-hmm. Now, take off your coat and stand on my scales. Mm-hmm. 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 Ooh, you are heavy. Get off my scales before you break them. The government does not want you to be this fat. If you look at my chart, you are here. You are a whale. The government does not want you to be a whale. The government wants you to be a pig. If you like, you can be an elephant, but you must never be an ant or people will squash you.
To be a rabbit?
No. Or I will eat you. Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, I want you to find one of your enemies, preferably one who is a pig. You must cut off the nail from the index finger of your enemy and eat it. While you eat, you must think of pigs. If you eat the wrong nail, you will live the rest of your life as a whale in Whip Snail Zoo. And they will never free really. This is your last appointment. Save yourself! Save yourself! Save yourself!
Helen, your CV's very impressive. You've shown a lot of initiative, which is something we take very seriously in this company. You're more than qualified for the job, and to be honest, you're the best candidate we've seen so far. So if you'd like the job, it's yours.
Thank you.
See you Monday.
Thank you very much.
I've got worms.
Thank you for coming, Mr. and Mrs. Yes, well, now the fact that you have sought marriage guidance means you want your relationship to work. So, bearing that in mind, try to be honest at all times. Remember, this is a safe place. I'm not here to judge you. So, why don't we start with you?
No, start with me. I want to go first.
Why should you go first? I am the man, so I say I am going first.
You're always first. You even die first.
Who said I will die first? Hopefully you will go before me, and maybe then I shall get some rest.
So now you're wishing your bad spirit on me? Pwah! I will never die. Touch wood.
Okay, why don't we start with you?
I've changed my mind. Let him go first.
Why should you tell me when to go? I am the man, so I say you are going first.
You see how violent he is? You know, sometimes he tries to kill me.
That is a lie. I never lay a finger on her. But in my country, I would have slapped her by now.
What can you slap, eh?
Come here. Oh.
Okay, Mrs. Let's try an exercise. I want you to look at your husband and say three things you love about him. In your own time?
Yeah. Three things. Mm-hmm.
Or just one thing? Anything?
You see how she's looking at me? The devil is in her eye.
I was about to say something sexy.
Yeah. Oh, yeah. You see, she's a witch. She's always casting a spell on me. One day, I woke up and I was bald.
You have alopecia.
That's a lie.
Eh? And how can I get you at night? You know, he makes me sleep in the basement.
But I'm sure he doesn't.
Are you calling my wife a liar?
How dare you? In my country, I would have slapped you by now.
What can you slap?
Stop it. You know I like it. That's my urogenezo. Come on. Hey. You naughty boy.
You dirty girl.
Come here.
Stop watching us.
Look away. You are a pimp.
The point of you coming here is that you can say things to each other that you are afraid to say to one another on your own. So, is there anything that one of you would like the other one to know?
Yes. I want to say something.
Good. I want you to turn to your wife and just be honest with her. Remember where you are.
Well, sometimes I am tired. I cannot make the love every Wednesday.
And why not? Am I not attractive?
You see this? Does this excite you? Look.
Now, Mrs. Okay, now your turn. Is there anything you'd like to say to your husband?
Maybe there is one thing. I used to be a man.
Excuse me, I saw that you just, you know, desiccated saliva vomination on the pavement there. You're not allowed to do that, you know that?
I won't do it, yeah.
You know it's not good. Let's walk and talk at the same time. Because I can see you're a learned man. Yeah. You're a very learned man, you're very tall. Uh-huh. Are you in the matrimoniality position?
What's that?
Matrimonial position to say that weddedness has entrapped you.
What is that?
Weddedness.
What is that?
Are you married?
Yes.
You're married?
You want to marry me?
That's not what I said. But if you are proposing to me, then I accept.
You're from Nigeria?
No, I'm from Rule Britannia. I'm from Rule Britannia, you see. Rule Britannia.
What's that?
You know the Queen? The Queen. You know the Queen?
The Queen.
The Queen. That's what I said, the Queen. We are very, very close friends. Her Majesty.
The
Queen. Sorry, when I think of the Queen, I have to just give her 2 minutes silence. Can you give her 2 minutes silence with me, please?
Are you okay?
2 minutes silence, please, for the Queen.
Little Christine.
Hi.
Oh my Lord, look at you. And this is your baby?
Yeah, she's 3 months now.
Oh, let me take a look at her. Oh, what a lovely pram. You take
you. Yes, I want your blood.
Babe. Babe.
What is it?
Is she supposed to be talking at this age?
I wouldn't call gurgling talking.
Okay.
Licky, licky, sucky, sucky.
Babe, she's talking again. Call my mum. That ain't right.
What are you on about? Mummy's tired because of all your talking. But you're too small to talk, aren't you? If you can talk, can you say mummy or daddy?
Eat shit in hell. You're not my real dad. Uncle Tony is.
Mum, I'll call you back.
Up.
That's 1 minute 45.
Hey, I
okay,
go.
You can move on.
Shall I come back?
No, no, coming, coming. Take off your hair and stand on the scale. Mm-hmm. Ooh, you are heavy. The government does not want you to be this fat. If you look at my chart, you are here. Good. Yes, the government does not want you to be dead. The government says, if you like, you can be here.
Disabled.
Yes, but the government does not want you to be dead. The government wants you to be here. So, every night, you must wear this bikini to bed and only dream of me. But if you dream of someone else, even your husband, you will die. So, this is your last appointment. Save yourself. Save yourself. Save yourself. Save yourself.
Yes, ma'am.
Madam President, as the first black female president, can we expect an amendment on your policies on diversity?
Get the fuck out of here, Thomas! I'm a bad mother. Shut your mouth. All my life, I was had to fight. When I see an elephant fly...
What you talking about, Willis?
How old is your baby?
He's 5.5 months.
You mind if I take a look?
No, sure.
Ooh, ooh, what a lovely ratul. You take care, you hear? God bless.
Thursday night comedy on BBC Two. It's a real selection box. Mock the Week, Hyperdrive and Still Game. Take your pick or pig out on all three tomorrow from 9.
The last game was outrageous and open. This one's sort of cagey and confined.
I think it's been a massive disappointment.
Look at this for a break. It's unbelievably good.
Once you give that penalty, he has to send Cavalier off.
I don't want to be too harsh. The first half was rank. How did he miss?
Cristiano Ronaldo, short back lift, and bullets it into the bottom left-hand corner.
Dan Agger's first goal for Liverpool.
The new season starts August the 11th across TV, radio, online and mobile. The language of football on the BBC.
It stretches thousands of miles and touches millions of lives. The story of a magnificent river, Ganges, Friday at 9 on BBC Two.
The BBC Proms, from Sunday to Tuesday at 7.30 on BBC Four. Be moved. this summer.